Okay, so today with the, what did I do last time? Mesh, I modified the mesh loaders and to add options for mesh loading. That was fine. Today I'm going to see if I can do something to do with targets, like frame buffer targets. The organization of several images together, like a color buffer, a depth buffer, and some others. Being able to specify them in a kind of systemic way, and of course use them, and like hopefully be able to reuse, or kind of if the idea eventually integrating it to more of a streamlined or systemic pipeline system. But first of all, I need to be able to organize these targets, and the goal I was hoping to do kind of today was to be able to figure out how to do MSAA. But that's kind of like a long shot, considering I basically at this point don't have any real specification for targets beyond like the swap chain images, I believe, which I'm just rendering straight to. So this is probably going to require two types of targets, a render target for swap chain targets, and then one for arbitrary like texture image target types. So, I am going to start with, we'll just create a new thing here. It's like render new plain struct that we're going to start with. So we start with that. Let's get some music on. There we go. Struct target. So I guess for the moment I'm going to focus on non-swap chain targets, I guess. I'm curious though. Can hold on. Yeah, can when I create a swap chain target, so when I regenerate these things way down here somewhere, rebuilding the swap chains, I have to specify the surface format. Present mode, and then I create it. Okay, so in here they'll be like this, right? Is there a thing for like samples? No. Which makes sense, I guess. You can't, I guess, evaluate the MSAA, the anti-aliasing, on a surface when it's being output. It has to be done from a render target with MSAA down onto this swap chain surface to then be sent out. Okay, so, I guess we'll start with this. What are we going to have? We're going to have, I don't know, is it? Okay, we need. For now, I'll just use Vulkan things directly. Got that. Got the extent. We'll have. We'll have like the right. Buffer. No, I can reuse the frame buffer for both reads and writes. So if I have a vector of VK frame buffer, let's say I have three in flight. One that's being actively written to, and then I can have up to two previous ones for reading previous information. That'll give me the flexibility to do like temporal anti-aliasing far into the future. Even if I don't use it now, I'd rather actually have the flexibility to kind of have it mostly there. And in the meantime, I could just have, you know, have a frame buffer size of one or two if I'm just having one read, one write, so on and so forth. But as long as I actually have like this kind of read buffer. So right now these can be pointers into this. Okay. The vector, the frame buffers, okay. So this is what it is now. I'll only want to change I need to be able to specify this, because this is what it is. I need to be able to specify like what kind of targets I have. So that's going to require something along the lines of target. Okay, I need some specifications. So I need like a standard vector of its specifications, where struct image spec will be a struct that'll be have, I guess for now, VK format. What would I need to start? I just the format, color, depth, whatever. Image, I guess usage, right? There's a usage flag. Hold on while I remember how I create images. Extent, MIP levels, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay, when I create an image, the format, the extent, the MIP levels, array layers. Okay, these are individual render targets. I don't want to array them. There's no MIP levels. I don't want to array them because then I'll, because I want to be able to recycle them individually as I'm running through them. This is what I'm looking for. VK image usage flags. Usage of the thing, and then I'm sure there'll be more things. Target specifications. So the idea being like we'll have which spec of, let's say, dot format. We'll have like a color. And then the depth. D whatever usage equals something. This would be like whatever VK format DGRA8 U norm. I don't know yet, but I'm thinking that's the idea. Have an array of those things, put that in the spec. That is used to create images. So I'll have to have something along the lines of, so this is the size that we want. We'll also have to have, like, you know, how many do we want? Something desired. Set count. How many sets of the target render target do I want? Frame buffer. So this is like the runtime stuff down here. This is the theoretical stuff. This is the stuff we want. This is what we have and what's set as we rotate through. So I'm going to need targets, individual targets themselves. The actual target, which will be like an image spec. And then we'll need the data that goes along with it, won't we? Should be like, you know. Specification paired with the image. Okay. Then we'll have a vector. The targets go in the frame buffer, which are derived from the image spec, creates the image, and the extent is like. Would I want something similar for the swap chain targets for both XR and regular? Okay, these swap chain images are generated way up here somewhere, because they don't change on a per session basis. Yeah, the okay, swap chains and that will be handled externally to these. So these will be specifically for or maybe I'll create another one that's kind of parallels this for swap chain targets. So that I can also like add depth and whatever to output swap chains. Perhaps. Okay. Okay, well, for the moment, let's just not have a read, let's just have a write. The current hat buffer, more like p current frame buffer. Do something like that. And then I'll probably want to have like stuff running on it from a different system or from external functions. Okay, let's see what. Going to take in okay, we'll do that. I'm gonna go through render target. I'm gonna go through the target specs. Create target that we're going to have something that's like, you know, create target data, and this will be the thing that will be abstracted based on the graphics backend. So we have to start with image data. We're going to start with target. Okay, we'll just not do image spec, we'll just say it's a spec. The specification. number of sets. Target specification equals that. Okay, we'll just start with that's not going to work, is it? Okay, we're not quite going to have that yet. Okay, for now I'm just going to make it a bit easier and just going to wholesale create all of the render targets immediately. Yeah. Okay, creating images. That view and the sampler. Do I have like any image type? I don't think I really have an image specific type here. These are all kind of still directly using Vulkan, yeah. That's like that, and VK sampler. Iterator, we got the number of sets of P under target. I need to create attachments. You know something like that. So we got VK image create info. So this stuff that we want the specification dot format will only be nip level of 1. The extent is the 3D. So that's one, Samples for now is 1. Tiling. We want it to be a sample bit, and we're going to have the other usage flags that we're going to have. So like that. We'll add the dot sharing mode. Exclusive. And then the initial layout. It's undefined, if I recall. Yes. Why do I not specify it here? Well, it's probably because this is 0, right? Yeah. That's probably also 0. Yeah, okay. I'm just going to add those there so it's explicit. Actually, I'll just leave it there for the moment. Okay, we got the create info. Then I need to lock CI. GPU only. I need the allocator. Okay, I need to really split this up into a CPP file as well. It's starting to get a little crazy. Then I need This is a new thing, so that. I'm really starting to think maybe I can actually split this off into some kind of common. Not quite yet. Not quite yet. Okay, we've got basically the same thing going on here. But we got go to create failed on failure. Have data.image. It's gonna be 1 0 1, yep. Yeah, data.view. Go through the sampler. Actually, no, do I need a sampler? I'm not quite thinking yet. You know what? Stay all the off the sampler for the moment. I'm not sure if I need that yet. So we can go back to here, we can get rid of the sampler. Because the sampler is kind of more like, what do you, how do you want to view it, rather than me knowing ahead of time which way you want to view it. Okay, let's say we went through this, we created the image view, however many times we needed. We passed, we go back to this, build render targets. We have this, we have the new target. And then I say, what, you know, what am I going to do with this render target? I'm going to, I'm going to say that the render target p dot that. Okay, I'm still trying to figure out the logic. I don't really know if I want to do that. Build new targets based on current specifications. Okay, I need to be able to, I need to actually clear out, if the prender, I need to clear out. How would I destroy this stuff? I would I need some kind of delayed buffered destruction, which means I kind of need a, I need some kind of like persistent state, which means I kind of need a system for render targets. Which means we need this. Thank you. Realistically, this would already be part of a part of a pool of some sort. Actually, there'll be a pool of render targets or something organizing them. I'm not quite going to touch that yet, though. But I do need. Do I need these? I don't think I need these quite yet. On the C++ side, I do. So that'd be instead. Process target. We'll just kind of focus on like we'll hand it individual targets and have it process them. The only thing I can think of that we'll actually be keeping at the moment will be just. Session, and then we're going to have the, I do have, how do I have delayed destruction, right? For things like this. How do I do it? How do I do it? I just have, yeah. Here we go. Chassis unload data. Then I just iterate through. Yeah, okay. Okay, so the unload data is basically these. Yeah. Perhaps. Should I rethink this? Perhaps. Okay, for the moment, it'll still remain this. That's the data we're moving over. So I still need, like. That's that. Mesh loader, we're going to have. Do I really need synchronization for this? Not really. I'm not adding them arbitrarily. It's always going to be done through this. We just need a vector. Of interest is the fact that I wouldn't actually be destroying things right away. You'd have to do like the. Not session, type S. Include that, okay. So if I'm doing it this way, render target, perhaps. I may actually. Okay, I'm thinking of reworking this again, perhaps, under the idea of. So these are still specs. These are things that are set, and then these are the things that are done through the processing down here. So we're gonna have standard vector of. Actually, this will be quite interesting. Would I want everything to shift up every time? Perhaps there could be some render targets you want to update like every other frame to try to like rear view cameras and vehicles and that. Like you don't need them to be done every frame, maybe every other frame. And then kind of rotate or spread them out a little bit so that's not in all that heavy all over the place. Don't know. I don't know. Each frame buffer. And this is a pretty okay concept. It'll be a standard vector of target data. So the spec it was built with. Well, realistically, the spec shouldn't change. Right, you would just create a new one of these. It's almost like a resource. Or would it? We have a set of data. A frame buffer. Associated with that frame data. Frame target, frame struct, frame data. Which will kind of encompass both target and frame buffers. At least just say, hey, it's just It sounds a bit better to me. Of course, it kind of screws this up a little bit. But I'm swapping out to this anyway, so let's get a little bit more on that render target system. We do that. Now, I'm pretty sure for other systems that I do have camera system. No, I don't. If it's already initialized, I don't actually have anything that it returns. Well, that's actually not a very good one either. Return that. Oh, right. Because what I was going to do with this is basically destroy the entirety of the render tag, which also means like any that are in flight. Even if I was going to delay the destruction for a couple of frames, that would also mean like I can't easily read that data. I'd have to rework it anyways to what I'm about to do. So I might as well just do it right now. Maintenance pass, which I'm not quite going to specify, but this is going to basically do. It's going to be doing that. So I'd also have to pass in like the 0, 1, 2, 3. So I'd also have to do So we start with the prender target, which we have. what we're going to do is we're going to say, hey, you know, so we have to start with, of course, if this is null pointer. Okay, I also need to include it. If it's null pointer. Create the first set. Do something. Okay, perhaps rather than a pointer, I'll just say it's unit or size t. Current frame and index if equals 0. Okay, first of all, I need to do something like if prender target set channel equals 0. If not empty, then I gotta go. I'm gonna go through. Okay, we'll do that. I need to specify what the current one is. It's a set of allocations and a frame buffer. We do all that, and then we add it to the unload data, shall we? Okay. Not really sure on this. This is basically just transferring stuff over to that. Okay, how do I do this? Frame sets, okay. 1, 2. Null pointer, null pointer, okay. It will be a what? If I had delete, delete, round back, okay. I just How do I initialize this? This is kind of a really interesting thing. I've created, let's say I created a process render target and I enter here, the set count is not zero, so I'm here. And then I need to say, hey, if current frame index, okay, we increment it. If frame sets dot size is less than or equal to render target current frame index, then we need to no, first of all, we need to determine if it's within the range. It's greater than or equal to, just in case it changed. Hmm. I'm in a bit of a hole right now. If it's that, then I need to get rid of a couple that are above and beyond that. So I need to go like prender. Then I'd go through all these, destroy these, basically like this. And then afterwards I go prender target. Framesets.resize down to the set count. This is, of course, making under the assumption that it's not being modified externally at this time. Can I ensure that? I can ensure that, but not quite yet. Now, otherwise, we need to okay. Now that we're at we're now here. Actually, no. If this frame set size is less than less than the value we're at right now. then I'm going to have to build up to the current index set. So I may have to skip like 0 and 1, or put an empty one, so until we find it, then we say, hey, auto and current frame equals e render target. Less that or equal to, like, I can go up to, so it has to be at least one more, yeah. Okay, now I can start rebuilding the stuff again. Okay, whatever. Back down here. Now I need to create frame data from the specification that I was given, which means now I need to go back to this stuff. So I have the current frame that I want to generate stuff for. So we have VK result for VK that. We want to include the code. So we want to go through current specifications, target specs. We want to generate them. Tying them together. Okay. For each of these. Okay. No. Current, we have current frame. Now we want to make sure if the specification already matches. Okay. How do I make sure the specification matches? Do I even want to try? Perhaps Okay, perhaps for now, I'll just always do it. Perhaps. So we go through generating stuff. So foe render target. It's not target anymore. I've got to go through image data. I'm going to copy this and reuse this. We're not going to do multiple, we're just going to do the one. So oh, right. Specification, there's nothing for that, but there is for extent. So we go through, we create all these data specs. Okay. If this, then we have to say Return the error code. No, not quite. What I'd want to do is actually I'd want to clear out anything that I haven't completed. Or... hour and a half. Not really getting very far yet. Okay, we're on the current frame. Reserve that many, then go forward and generate the images for it. Then we'd have to go through and we have to create the frame buffer for it. I'd also have to be able to create like a I need a render pass for frame buffer, wouldn't I? Okay, so I'd need to be able to. I just need a compatible render pass, which means if I believe graphics VK does have something for render passes. No, there is not. Cool. Render pass pool is here. Okay, and where do I have these things? Please tell me there, there. And then I have it as an independent thing that I have to give into. Okay. Render. Render pass pool. Now we're back down to here where we're going to say, hey, this equals this. I need to actually include. This is something I haven't touched in a long time. I'm sure this is not going to work at all, but I do have attachment descriptions. just that. Okay. Not good, not good, not good. Okay. I just need one that's compatible. I don't need a specific one. If I recall how frame buffers, you just need, yeah, so like if it's the same format and sample count, those are the things that matter, then I can work with it. Okay, I need to modify the render pass pool before I go any further here. Do I want to do like two separate arrays or like kind of have them twin together? For simplicity's sake, I think I'll just leave them separated like that for now. Okay, we're in the path pool. This is still actually in the generic one, even though it's Vulkan specific right now. Not great. And then I could just create a garbage generic one if I don't have one. Is my mind. So. What are we going to do? We're going to need. What is this? What is this? Pass compatible keys. We don't have attachments. Okay. But I still need that. I still need that. Okay. Gonna reserve formats.size. Then we're gonna go through four. Index, okay. got all those, and then we need to okay, what's going on? Get the render pass, shared read mode, otherwise we need to create the render pass. And I'd have to create a variant key. Okay. Oh, I don't have variant keys. Okay. Do I have like a finding a render pass in? Okay, I need another finding render pass variant. Which is just going to be the compatibility keys. Why are these copies? I don't understand. We're just going to go through the render passes. We've already locked it, presumably. It's over here. Need to go through for the first variant. If there are any. Okay. Okay. So I need to create a variant key. So this is what? Is this going to have to be the same size? Oh, the variant is all. Oh, yes, I can. Yeah. I can say it's the size of formats.size, and it's that many copies of that, this, which will be like dot load up equals, right, it's this? No. Go to this. Yeah, okay, equals what? Load up, let's just say, don't care. We just say don't care for everything, I guess. Drop don't care. It starts at that, and the final layout will be typically VK. Shader read only optimal. That's typically going to be the most common case. So the most common case will be actually VK attachment, store up, store. Loading don't care, typically, or it's a clear. Don't care. Yeah, I'll go with that. Okay. How do I? I need attachments to generate a render pass, which are what? What do I use them for? Okay, I need to be able to generate render passes. Oh, and this is still wrong? Find render pass. Oh. Okay. I'm losing my mind. So many variables in my mind. I need to generate. Going to be based out of compatible keys. variant keys. Keys and keys, generic attachments. There's a lot of information, pretty dense for only 310 lines. Compatibility keys, generate variant keys. It will have another one down here just underneath, which is to generate attachments from those key sets. So basically I can go from one set to the other or vice versa, which isn't too bad actually. It's interesting. Okay, generate attachment description. So making this, no, we'll just say size key. Index equal 0, index less than, let me just say I cut. Do I want to make this a function? I don't really have to, do I? No. DK attachment description. It's going to be what? At least I don't think there's any other locations I'm going to be using this. Where's the data? Compatible keys and the variant. Okay. This look like, what do I need? Okay. Okay. It leaves like, what is this, flags? Load up, store up, stencil up, and then, okay, so it's just these things. Going. Long double click. Compatible keys. I dot samples. Okay, fine. We'll change it around to be that. Or no, it's just Static cast, you happy? Yes. Generate attachments, which attachment description, sorry. Okay, we have that. Now we can generate the render path. Attachments. We'll retry this just in case it was something. It's a scoped lock instead of a shared lock. Yes, correct. If we still can't find it, then we generate it. Also correctly unlocks on the way out. I don't know if this even works. Two hours. Okay, I need to pause, grab a drink, ruminate, go into despair, and then continue. BRB. Okay, I'm back. This is going to be fun to watch happen, but I need to complete the rest of this to get it to work properly. So what was it? It was going to be set of formats, correct? Or something along those lines. How was I going to do this? Okay, I need four. Okay, I need to. I need to go through each of them and get the formats together, and then okay, I'm not entirely sure what I need for this, but I'm okay. Let me determine what I need for frame buffers, because I'm pretty sure attachments. I need a set of attachments, which for the frame buffer, which are like image views. So .s type equals decay structure. We need that, we need compatible render pass, which we're working on, attachment count equals attachments dot size. And then we're gonna have image views, yes. One layer. Okay. So I need to go through with formats and that to to... Okay, I need three sets. Okay. Samples, and then we need a standard vector of VK image view. And we're going to go through all of the specs. We can actually do this here, can't we? Almost. Just doing sample one for the moment. Attachments.inPlaceBack, data.view, which we just generated. Okay, and then this will give me formats and samples to put in here. Okay, width and height. How did I set that? Just extent, right? Okay. With all of that, then I need to create the frame buffer. So I'm not properly cleaning things up here either. I'm going to have to... do that eventually. we got that. Let's clean up. Okay, this file is no longer required. It's just that. We need to add this. Get rid of the functions. Don't need that anymore. That anymore. Memalloc, VK, yes. Okay. Cute. I did not include log. Did I? I'm sorry, no, this is the wrong one. Here. Oh. This is not returning something it should be. Okay, application. Let's create one. So I will, in the main loop, but not quite here, just up at the top here somewhere. We're gonna have a new, render target and include target system. Okay. To have some like that, I'm going to say whatever. I just want to make sure that they exist. Test target dot targets. Specs. Okay, I need a set count of, let's say, 2. We're going to have 2 sets. Test target. Dot. Extent. Target specs. Spec one, and we have a second spec, and then we're gonna, or more. So let's say we have the most basic things. We're gonna have equals VK format R8G E8A. U norm usage color attachment bit. Let's say that. A second one. Actually, no, for now, let's just make sure that the one works. So we're going to have test target system in the okay, let's see how badly I screwed up. Spending 2 hours on about 230 odd lines of code. Okay, this is unfortunate. It's going to go like to that, but you know, whatever. It is less than that. So P render target frame sets. Okay, we carry on. So we don't have to remove any. One, two, okay. We now have two frame sets, which should be blank. Yeah. There's nothing to delete here. Yeah, this is going to very quickly run out of items to out of space. So. So we got a spec data. I'm going to do this. That needs to be empty. Okay, we have data. We don't actually have data. I didn't actually do anything. You see, because I am not great. Okay, do that again, now that I actually passed the data, although I'm not doing it safely. Gonna have to... So there, we actually have data this time, yes. Only have the one right now. Okay, let's see how this works. I'm not sure if I actually have anything in here. No, I don't. So, generate that, which gives me this, which gives me this. I don't find one, so I generate one using this. Yeah, okay, this makes sense. And then I actually generate a compatible render pass. Okay, so that actually works out just fine. Okay. Okay, now I need to run maintenance to clear out the old systems as quickly as possible. Otherwise, I'll just run out of memory real fast. Standard error code. Just do void. The unload list. So we'll move it forward by one. Yeah, just the same thing as usual. Gotta go for auto iterator through to unload. Then I gotta go through these, which means handle. Gotta go through each of these.
Then we're gonna do image destroy image, which takes the allocator.
Okay. Do that. So maintenance a bunch of times to clear anything out. And then what I'll do here beforehand is I'll have like a function that hooks into the render target pool, and it'll automatically just unload or set everything to be unloaded. Then run maintenance a bunch of times, which will get rid of them. I think. Eventually. And then this time we start getting into stuff that actually did exist. Going ahead and starting to delete it. Okay. Still really, really fast. We exit, but I don't even have the Vulkan sanitizer on. So I don't know. I'm presuming everything is fine. Has a number of items that were not destroyed. Actually, that makes sense because I don't have a clearing function, but it is just a few items. So this will be the last ones. 1, 2, 1, 2. So it's just the last two that were in here before I leave. Which does make sense. Okay. So something I need in the spec is the number of this. I need to have this specified as well. Thank you. that needs to be passed through. So to here. What is it actually like specified in here? It's samples. Okay, we have the correct samples, because the samples would have been, that's how we turn on MSAA, isn't it, if I recall, I think. Maybe. Pretty sure. Okay. So, got that render target. Let's try to do a second one for render target spec. We're going to have the 32s float. Let's just say, yeah. How badly that screws up. Is it not? Oh, there it is. Yeah, okay. Okay, destruction. Yeah, some things left over. VK object type image. Own depth only image formats must have the VK image aspect depth bit set. Okay. I need to make sense, right? I'm just assuming that these are always image usage sampled. Okay. Where would it be? It'd be like under here. Yeah, this is where it'd be. Okay. Okay. I'm kind of reaching the limit of what I can do on this today. What I will do though is I will finish up render pass pools just a little bit. One thing I do need to add to the variant that I don't think is part of the compatibility key is the flags for the attachments. If I double check the attachment description, these. Even if there's none of these currently, I don't think there are. Oh, there are actually, may alias. So I need to have that as part of the variant key here before I forget it. If before I just, yeah. So, we'll add that. Flags. Okay. Okay, we'll do it as a two-parter. So one thing I do probably want to do first, render pass pool there, is specify why these are different. So. Actually, that doesn't make sense. This is going to be changing for that anyways. What does matter, though, is this.
If the
yeah. Okay. Nine months ago. Whoa. I've been at this for 9 months. Presenting a basic cleared surface to a window. Ooh. Feels like I haven't gotten very far. Okay, first part. So get rid of the image loader. First, yes, add this. Actually, no, don't add this. This is just doesn't matter. There's zeros. So what I want to add is that and that. And these. Right, because they were updated for that. Not the most basic one possible. Oh, I don't actually want to put this on. Under targets, put it on there. One thing, and then I'll kind of leave it here for the moment. 2 hours, 40 minutes, yeah. So that'll be like our part one of render target stuff. Cheers.